Hi everyone, on today's episode, I'm going to make myself some coasters using this dichroic film, and I've also got myself a little helper.
Hi everyone.
Now the first thing we're going to do is mix up some resin, then we're going to add some black pigment paste and pour ourselves a base layer.
The resin we'll be using is Artcast, and the pigment is Phantom Black.
Looks like we made enough resin to make four coasters. So now we're just going to leave this to sit until it nearly cures. We don't want it to fully cure, we want it to stay a little soft, and we'll explain why a little later. So it's now time to work on our film. Now I don't have fantasy film, I've got some of this dichroic film. It's a little bit thicker, but I think it'll still work. Wow, how cool does that look? It's like bluey purple.
A bit of green in there too.
Yeah. How does yours look? Oh yeah. Got some gold in it even, I think.
Yeah, I can see some purple.
Wow, cool. Alright, so the next thing we need to do is cut ourselves some squares. So now that we have our four pieces of film, the next step is to take a heat gun and shrink it. Well, as you just saw, you've really got to take your time with this. You don't want to burn it, you just want to crinkle it up a little bit. I think for this next piece, I'm going to try scrunching it up first and then hitting it with a heat gun. So now that I've shrunk all four pieces, it's time to make a template of our mold and cut these out.
Now that we've got our template, we can cut out our four circles. Now don't worry about all these offcuts. I'm going to save these for another project.
So now that that film's cut, it's time to turn our attention back to this resin. Now what I'm waiting for is I'm waiting for this resin to become thick and tacky. Now the reason for that is I want to take my dichroic film and I want to push it into the black. That way I can hide all the edges. While I'm waiting for this resin to firm up, I want to take the opportunity to thank all my channel members. Thanks guys, I really appreciate your support. Now let's check on this resin. Still not quite there. I reckon we got about another 10 minutes. Okay, that's looking pretty good. It's time to put on our gloves and insert this film. Now the reason we waited for this resin to become tacky is that we want to push these pieces of film down and expose them on the other side. So all we have to do now is leave these to cure. Well, as you can see, these look a little different to when you last saw them, and that's because off camera, the film started floating up and we had to keep pushing them back down. But now that they're all down and set, we can mix up our clear and pour over the top. Now because we're using clear resin this time, we're going to degas it in the resiner's machine. So now that we have our crystal clear resin, we can pour it over these coasters. Now if you guys want to try the resiner's machine for yourself, I'll leave a link in the description of where you can find it, and if you use code BENSWORKS, you'll also get a discount. Now all we have to do is leave these to cure. So it's now the next day, it's time to take the cover off and have a look.
Oh no.
I don't know if you guys can see that. A bit of the film lifted up. Oh no. That's no good. Let's take them out and see how they look.
The black didn't turn out very well.
No,
it's not dark enough.
Yeah, it's not very dark, is it? That's not really the look we were going for. Well, that one's a little better. Still, the black's not dark enough. Let's check these other two. Nah, doesn't look very good either. Oh.
That's even worse.
That's bad.
The other side's okay.
Yeah, that side looks good. Just not what we wanted, though.
That's all right, we can try again.
Yeah, I think we're going to have to. I think we need to make our black darker and try to make sure that the film doesn't stick up.
Maybe we need to heat it more.
Yeah. All right, we're going to try this again. Okay, it's now time to take a look at our second lot. Oh, wow. Wow,
they look really good.
Yeah, they do look good.
Oh, a bit of an air bubble.
Oh, no. That's all right. The important thing is what they look like underneath. Okay.
It's not too bad.
It's kind of what we were going for. We just need a bit more of it.
Oh. That one's not great.
Nah, that's a bad one. Not much there at all. Okay.
That one's a bit better.
There we go.
I like that one.
That's kind of what we're going for. You guys see that? That's not bad either.
Yeah, I like that.
What do you think of that?
Yeah.
And the last one.
No, it's not too bad. Yeah, just wish it was more widespread.
Yeah. Okay. So even though these ones look pretty good, it still isn't quite the effect we were going for. We're really hoping for this film to poke through a bit more. So off camera, we tried it again.
How cool do these look now?
Look at these. That looks amazing. That's exactly what we were going for. And you know what else looks cool? When you put them on a light. Look at that. How cool does that look? I reckon you can make some awesome display stands like this. That looks cool too. And that one. They all look good. I really like these ones. Well, they do say practice makes perfect. And after seeing our results, I think it's true. I think what I might do with these is I'm going to sign the tops of them all and then randomly add them into people's Etsy orders. Well, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this one. Let me know which one you liked. I really liked these ones, but then if you turn these up the other way, I think they look even better.